your psychology will not revolve your will not revolve around your own identities too much. You will not be thinking about yourself too much. The amount of thinking that happens throughout the day will reduce. Udasinata will come towards your own identities. If it is a very general conversation, suppose 3-4 people are sitting, and if it is a general conversation, and suppose I say something about, let's say, I would say I have a back pain or something. Okay, I will tell my back is aching, I think some problem is there, I will tell something about my back pain. Immediately in that group, they are least bothered about my back pain anyway. They will start talking about their health problems immediately. The moment you speak about your back pain, they start speaking about theirs. The moment you start speaking about something, it may be even a neutral concept. If there is a dog sleeping in front of you very nicely, and if you say, see how nicely the dog is sleeping, one of the person will say, I didn't sleep properly today. Who's talking about you? Why are you talking about yourself? Because no matter what you see, you want to talk related to you and talk about myself. Too full of yourself. Whatever is spoken, you want to speak about yourself. It may be negative also. It's not always positive, but somehow you want to speak about yourself. If I say something negative also, if I say, this particular habit is there of mine, I'm trying to get rid of it, it's not at all going away. For example, if I say coffee, I don't want to drink coffee, but still somehow, urge is very strong, I go and drink. The other person will say, You are nothing, I have so many habits. They are also competition. Somehow you want to have the upper hand. Stick out and I am the hero here. No matter what word you use, they will start speaking about themselves. And many a times, this is what counseling is. Many a times people don't want a solution, they just want to have some outburst. Talk about themselves, because nobody is listening to them, probably. They want to come and talk about themselves for half an hour. They don't want a solution, they are not looking for a solution, because there is no solution anyway. They will talk, and finally they'll say thank you and go away. They're not looking for a solution also. Sometimes they will come, sir, I have a question. They'll come. They will only give a speech and go away. They just want somebody to listen to their misery. If you really want a solution, you will listen more, you will not talk more. But usually people talk more. That's how counseling happens most of the times. Because so much is held within, suppressed within. Most of the counseling is only exhausting it, not listening. They are anyway not looking for a solution. Therefore, I don't do counseling. And sometimes people will come and I want 5 minutes of your time, 10 minutes of your time, I have something to ask. I used to give, now I no more give like that. So I'll give, okay, fine, meet me at this time, that time. They'll come. And after that, it's not, I'm giving an additional point now. It's not only that they will go on expressing their misery. After talking for 5-10 minutes, they'll start advising me. What are you doing here? You are a volunteer, you should think about your security. Idiot, who called you? You called me. Why are you giving me advice? I'm telling people, lose track. They are themselves crying and they're giving me advice as to what I should do about my future. No, I'm telling this now to exhaust myself. because I cannot tell that they'll tell this on their face. I will put it on YouTube, they'll watch. It has happened many times, not once or twice. Many times. They ask, they called me to ask questions so that I will give answers. Forget me giving answers, they are giving me answers now. That grab goods and that life advice they are giving me. Not everybody, some people are sensible. But I've seen this many times happening. Not only advise me, they'll start commenting on the whole place now. Slowly. If you talk for a few more minutes, they are no more talking about their misery because they are already exhausted. Now they are jobless. And they'll start finding problems everywhere now. This has to be done in this place, that has to be done in this place. And finally I somehow tell them I have a class and I go away. That is one advantage of lectures. I have written this in Yoga Philosophy book. In lectures you can convey hard-hitting points openly. One-to-one counseling you cannot. You have to be It's very torturing. Even if the person is acting very idiotic, you cannot tell it on their face. Very difficult. Therefore, whenever people come to me for such things, I tell them, come to my lecture. I will counsel you like this. What? I cannot scold you directly, therefore I'll scold you like this.